Welcome to the beautiful Pacific Northwest of the United States of America. In this travel documentary, we explore the rugged nature of the very scenic Pacific Highway, the 101. With every twist of the road, there's a new picture. Wide sandy beaches are followed by a rocky shoreline, and a sparkling white lighthouse could highlight a sunset. Historic old places offer modern facilities. But first, some friendly advice. Now, sit back and enjoy the Pacific Coast. From the Olympic National Park down to the Redwoods, and as a bonus, Crater Lake National Park.
Coming from British Columbia, our landing in Washington State.
We are doing a bit of sightseeing in Port Angeles and putting our personal stamp on this big cedar stump. One mask is alive, but the other one is dead. And that's what you get.
It's octopus.
First highlight and overnight camping place is Hurricane Ridge. We will spend the rest of the day up here, do some hiking, have a lunch, and enjoying the scenery all around us. It is a picture perfect day for sightseeing and hiking. Best place for an overlook over the Wanderfuka Strait, and in the background is British Columbia, Vancouver Island. On our way down the mountain, we stopped at this patch of fireweed and took a close look what the bees are doing. The size of the big trees dwarf our van at our first campsite. The next day, we're heading for the center of the rainforest, and this is it. It's about 550 years old and 12 and a half feet in diameter. From the very beginning on, the lush greenery of the rainforest hits you with surprise. Everything is covered with moss. It hangs down from every branch, every tree, and drapes the area like a curtain, sometimes so profuse that it shuts out the sunlight. It's a very mysterious place, and if you like to see a ghost, this is the place to be. This is also the place where you can let your imagination run freely, because the variations of color and light, of form and figure, are an endless expression of art in nature. The reason for this bewildering growth is the area has hardly been touched by humans for centuries, and I hope it will stay like this forever. No commercial logging has ever taken place. but the play of light and shadow is very intriguing. The abundance of the plants and mosses are due to the high rainfall. It is the area of the highest rainfall in the United States. The yearly rainfall can be as high as 15 feet, 5 meters. The amount of mosses hanging down the trees is overwhelming. The brown area is dried up moss. One nursing log has produced all these big trees. Lined up like on a clothesline, they grew out of one tree. Take a look at the comparison of man and tree. Picture taken is a prime force here, and poets, painters, and plumbers are often heatedly debating the nature of things. Why plumbers? Because the rainforest could not exist without a good plumbing system.
Oh. You're up there.
You got sidetracked.
A duo company.
Another beautiful example of a nursing log. It's pretty foggy today, and we're hoping that it will lift. Lots of driftwood around, and the sound of the surf is never ending. Wow, what a humongous tree stump that is. On the beach, there's always noise from the wind and the waves.
Pelican!
Pelican?
Yes.
A pleasant surprise. We did not expect to see pelicans. The way they are gliding over the water is quite amazing. Real windsurfer. This is our first mile on the coast, only another 1,000 to go. The next day, with the fog gone, we decide to stay another day and explore the area. This is the beauty of a camping trip. There is no fixed schedule and you're not bound to a certain location. Now and then I go on little adventure trips, reminiscent of a useful bus, but age doesn't stop thinking young. Driftwood galore and fantastic expressions of figures and form.
Somebody is riding on an elephant.
Take note what I come up with.
The beach watching monster will grow in size. One day, to heaven, it'll rise.
What a lucky strike to find this beautiful foreground. When I got back to the campsite, the sun came out again. Another beautiful morning is just the right way to start our lighthouse tour. We came here especially for that, and we are not disappointed. However, the name says exactly the opposite. This is the lighthouse of Cape of Disappointment at the mouth of the Columbia River. Right here, the Columbia River flows into the ocean, and on the other side, the state of Oregon begins. From our campground, we can walk to two lighthouses within 2 hours' time. The hiking provides good opportunities for picture taking. After we watched the boy climbing up, and Red had challenged me to do the same, there wasn't an easy way getting out of it, so I had to do it. Coming down from the lofty heights, we want to trace the footsteps of the great explorers Lewis and Clark, seeking out secluded beaches, climbing up steep hills and cliffs to get overlooks of the area and take photographs after. Commemorating the great explorers, Lewis and Clark. The next few pictures are typical for this area. Slugging it out in the rain, I would call it.
Rain is considered liquid sunshine here.
As you can see, the rain doesn't prevent people from horsing around.
Pelicans. Very interesting how they follow their leader.
Even so, it was a dreary day. There still was a rich bounty of photographs. the door opens to famous Cannon Beach, and we get a look of the even more famous monolith, the haystack of the ocean.
Again, a very cloudy day, but it makes it more interesting. Young people always find something new to have fun with. The landscape of the Pacific shoreline is so engaging, dramatic, interesting, peaceful, just a wonderful place to visit and drive alongside the Highway 101.
Every sunset is different, and I try to capture the moods. South, we meet a lot of bicycle riders. Here comes happiness. It's no disguise. It is happiness by surprise. We change course with a last-minute discovery of a remote recreation area for off-road vehicles. For us, it will be the first sand dunes, and we just plan to spend a quiet, relaxing day. Hopefully, we can sneak some fun in there. Henriette has a bit of trouble coming down, but I will show her the easy way.
That looked like fun. Try again.
Okay. Sehr gut.
A tip in the water cools down the exuberance. What you don't see doesn't hurt as much. Makes sense? Of course.
The sand dunes are beckoning to be explored a little closer. Just a relaxing vacation day. Look interesting.
A lot of our camping neighbors have off-road vehicles, and we go around inspecting them. My favorite hour of the day is coming. Not a soul around to disturb the solitude, and I can concentrate just on the sunset.
Getting deeper into sand dunes country, but today we are watching some surfboard riders, which are coming up pretty soon. Nice ride. Beautiful updrifting spray.
Going south to Florence on the 101
highway
at famous Seal Rock. All seals were gone, so we drove on to our next station, the Oregon Dunes Lighthouse, which was the location of our campsite. The dunes are a unique area, especially enjoyed by off-road vehicle enthusiasts.
The sand dunes go right down to the beach, an invitation for a nice leisurely walk. A brisk wind is blowing, kicking off the waves in the water, creating a very scenic spray in the air of wind, wave and water. To see the wild, windswept ocean waves, a very dramatic sight to experience.
It does look pretty stormy, but in reality it's quite pleasant, warm, and it's an enjoyable stroll on the beach.
A very different environment close by. There does not seem to be any noise restrictions on those vehicles.
The dunes are spread out over a large area, around this time not very busy. That was one of the few noisemakers.
This is a landscape totally new to us. On a steep uphill climb.
A couple of days later, we're leaving, but not before shooting an obligatory sunset. We have found another off-road location that might be interesting and heading towards it. This is our surprise for the day, and we are anxious with anticipation.
A happy senior meeting. The rugged shoreline is always asking for stopovers, take a break from driving.
This side trip will cost us a day, but we're already happy having taken it. The main attraction is still to come, which is the botanical garden. Approaching the gardens, we are wondering what we will find blooming in mid-September. And I hope I will remember. In the middle of September, we have found a botanical garden that is full of blooms. Just beautiful to photograph.
Which means we must have moved into a different time zone.
Still on our side trip, another attraction is heading our way, unexpected, a large herd of sea lions and seals. What we missed at Seal Rock, we are catching up now.
The noise caught our attention from far away. That's also the reason for not getting a clear picture. There was a nice trail along the shoreline for observation of the seals.
This was a welcome surprise.
We just took a chance on stopping after a long drive.
Venturing off the beaten paths rewarded us again, and we enjoyed watching the seals. The next day, back on the main road, We're still thinking about the nice events of yesterday, but soon this landscape captures my full attention. Today our campground is underneath this bridge, and the only energy left over we reserve for the sunset.
Finding a campsite is a daily adventure because we have no fixed schedule, just stop wherever we feel like it. And every sunset is the highlight of the day.
Sunrise the following morning. And there's a lot of road ahead of us.
This looks like a perfect place for making a break from diving and stay for a couple of hours. The feet need stretching and the camera needs picture taking.
There is the busy 101 highway
behind us.
One of the most scenic ocean view highway
we have driven lately.
It's much more pleasant walking on the beach than sitting in the car and driving.
The wind leaves various patterns behind.
Just what the doctor ordered, alone on the beach for a nice relaxing stroll. Only a short distance off the main road, this natural bridge is located. This indicates the end of our stay in Oregon, and we are moving on to the next state.
Our destination are the Redwoods in the state of California.
Our campsite is right in Jediah Smith Redwood Park. This way we can walk over this troubled bridge of rough waters straight into the Redwood Grove. In the Stout Memorial Grove are standing some of the largest and oldest samples of redwood. Walking amongst those giants makes humans very small. But when you discover that some of those trees were standing here when Christopher Columbus discovered America, then you know a human lifetime is also very small. Some of the trees have grown here over 2,500 years. The tallest ones are 300 feet high and 12 to 15 feet in diameter. We were told you could build 3 to 4 one-family houses out of one tree. That represents a substantial economic value. But we are only interested from the environmental point of view which means protect, preserve, and leave them standing for future mankind.
Hopefully, the protection given to the trees will make them survive another century.
Now comes wishful thinking on my part, while Henriette has planted her feet solidly on ground. Let's walk on with music as company.
Notice the size of the tree compared to the human body.
As you might have noticed, I like walking on those giant trees. Some of them with a diameter of 3 meters. Just running a check on the circumference of those big trees, it really makes one feeling very, very small. Our circle tour is almost over, and tomorrow we are planning to drive through the Redwoods to various locations. Coming up is the second day of our stay in the Redwoods. For this gravel road, our van just barely meets the maximum allowable size to drive here. The next few minutes are a real life driving sensation. It's a very rough road with only a few places to stop.
This groove is mainly intended for driving through. The road is also very narrow and winding.
We slowed down almost to a stop to get out of the shaking, but soon we will be out of the woods anyway. A good half hour later, we're out of it, and we're taking a breather at the ocean shores. We're lucky and spot pelicans again. It's interesting to watch those pelicans skim over the water, and then we are heading back into the rainforest.
This is again a different groove.
Careful, there is no net. If you fall, broken bones you will get.
Meeting giant trees just laying on the ground. The giant root system.
As usual, it's pretty dark in here, even with the sun shining. As a former countryman and Grazer, I want to show off the achievements of Arnold.
It is quite amazing that he served as governor of California. The fierce windstorm from the ocean keeps killing the trees. He is a keen walker.
This is going to be a big jump down, almost 3 meters. Worked out well. This shows a comparison between man and nature. Is this the origin of the mask in Star Wars, Darth Vader? Up to now we haven't seen much of wildlife. Now we get a glimpse of it. Danger is closing in. In the form of a herd of elks.
We almost gave up seeing some wildlife, but today we did.
What a beautiful specimen. Before we leave the Redwoods, we want to take one more picture of the biggest cedar tree there is, an enormous tree with a diameter of more than 15 feet, so well over 4.5 meters in diameter. Then it will take us a good day's driving to come to our last feature presentation. Great Lake is an extinct volcano. The last eruption was 40,000 years ago. It is the highest and deepest lake of North America, with an elevation of 6,000 feet and a depth of almost 2,000 feet. In the metric world, that would be 600 meters deep and 2,000 meters high. A beautiful road, 30 miles long and with numerous lookouts, circles the crater. This breathtaking, supernatural environment is like a strike of gold. Can't keep my finger off the trigger.
At the bottom, the Phantom Castle.
A side trip to volcanic erosions called the binnacles. All those columns you see are hollow inside, originating from the last eruption, which was 40,000 years ago. In the meantime, the weather kept working on the sandstone, eroding it continually, changing the shapes as they do their work. It's a pretty interesting place. Totally different from the rest of it.
At the bottom there's a creek flowing, and we're using every point of interest to make a stop.
Back at the rim road, the highest elevation of the road is 8,000 feet, so 2,400 meters. We're making one discovery after another one. Come, take a look with us. Pretty amazing.
We are totally in awe what we're seeing here, and all is originated from an extinct volcano.
White bark mountain pine. The only tree that can survive the harsh climate that exists up here.
popular name for this bird should be Whiskey Jack, but I don't know. Oh, this is a terrific place for mountain bikers. The scenery would be jaw-dropping.
Above our heads, a hawk circles looking for prey.
What a beautiful sky to soar and spread your wings for more. The water is a reflection of the sky.
Daily boat tours cruise the lake. This is the lookout at the northern entrance of the park. And we find a lot of chipmunks scurrying around.
Coming up, a short description.
At this very spot, in the year of 1853, a gold-seeking miner stood and gazed upon this beauty, probably just like I do right now, in bewildered amazement. He didn't find any real gold, but upon his return, he told the world, "What I saw is just like gold." Think of it for one moment, red hot lava spewing out of it.
We are waiting down here for the sun to set, and so do the other people.
This means the end of this presentation is coming soon, but it was not the end of the trip. More about this in the next film.
Thank you for watching. Goodbye, au revoir, und auf Wiedersehen.